My name is Karl Pritchard, and I'm living with bladder cancer. When I found out I had bladder cancer, I was fat, dumb, and happy, just walking along, and then all of a sudden, I had some symptoms. That's when the doctor said, uh-oh, and something's wrong. And all of a sudden, my world turned upside down, so I wasn't fat, dumb, and happy anymore. When I found out I had the cancer, I looked into various types of treatments. I did a lot of research on the web, but I didn't have a lot of choice. My local urologist told me that surgery was my only option. It was so severe. What would happen after the surgery, nobody was discussing at the time. Everything was, we'll wait and see. What's interesting about this is after my surgery, my oncologist told me that I was not eligible for chemo because my kidneys were not functioning properly. And so I asked him about immunotherapy. I asked him, and he said he'd never heard of it. This was the oncologist at the hospital. I went back to my hometown and I had to see the oncologist there because even though they couldn't give me chemo, they'd be there for any other care I might need related to the cancer that they knew was still in my body somewhere. And I talked to the doctor there and she was very nice. And on my second meeting with her, I asked the doctor about the immunotherapy and it was really a really good idea because she knew about it, but it never occurred to her to mention it to me because for them it was a brand new thing. Well, I had two options. I could be interested or I could go arrange my final affairs, you know. So naturally I was interested. What I should describe extreme fatigue, I think, and that is that you don't realize, I didn't realize, I was fatigued at all or tired. I felt like I could go out and plow the North 40 without the help of a horse. But by the time I got outside the front door, I was too pooped to do anything but sit down. You feel great, but it just isn't there. The fatigue is still there, but it's not quite as extreme, but yes, it is there. If I go for a long walk, I will know it. And there's a great many things I can no longer do. And some of it's good because, for example, because of my surgery, I'm not allowed to lift more than 10 pounds. But I can't do any really heavy work anyway anymore. I get too tired too soon. And that's a change that I have to adapt to. And that's been a painful learning experience. I had my first treatment in the beginning of February of 2014. And I had a CAT scan every 2 months following that. And in the first CAT scan, they defined two very large tumors, very clear. In my next CAT scan, 2 months later, they defined two very small tumors with, I think they said, indistinct margins. The third CAT scan, they said there might be an indistinct mass down there, we can't tell. By the fourth CAT scan, they just said there's nothing there. And that was in the early fall of 2014. I'm on an extended trial now, but it's not to cure the cancer. It's for whatever else they want me to keep me on it for. I think the future, well, first of all, I think about the future now, and I didn't think about the future after my surgery. I thought I had no future, but my outlook has changed completely after the immunotherapy has been so successful for me. I'm still vertical, and I've been vertical for, well, my surgery was 2.5 years ago, and I've been on this stuff over 1.5 years, and, I think it's the cat's meow. It's the best there is. I can't think, chemo wouldn't have put me here, and I don't know what else would have put me here. Immunotherapy came along at just the right time. Of course, if it came along a little earlier, I wouldn't complain.